Bible says in Psalm 119, verse 17, before we have our seat tonight, it says, deal bountifully with thy servant, that I may live and keep thy word. Deal bountifully with thy servant, that I may live and keep thy word. One prayer point you're going to take before you have your seat tonight. We're standing on Psalm 119, verse 17. Father, deal bountifully with me tonight. That it says that I may what? Live. There is no man that God deals bountifully with that dies. If you're experiencing death of any kind in your life, it means that you are not enjoying God's bountiful impact in your life. Simple prayer. Father, tonight, deal bountifully with me. Meaning, God will make tonight your own date with destiny. So you're going to pray. I don't know why you came. You know, everybody came with different reasons. Everybody know why they are here. Today is a day not meant for jokes. It's a date with destiny. Only the Lord knows why he said the 8th and the 28th of each month, seek my face and avail yourself physically. You're going to lay your hands on your head. If you want to kneel, I'll give you this one, 3 minutes you will pray. You want to roll on the floor, you want to kneel down, you want to, whatever you want to do. You lay your hands on your head and you cry, my Father in heaven, deal bountifully with me that I may live. The word live there is not just having oxygen. Some people are breathing, they are alive but not living. It's one thing to be alive and be living at the same time. When things are not working for you, you are just passing through time but not living a mark in time. This same period where the pandemic has hit humanity, some people have been made bankrupt, businesses liquidated, but on the contrary, some have become multi-millionaires. The same time where there is a casting down for some people is also a lifting up for some. There is a saying in England, this country we live, our beautiful country, that say, is sira sira, what we be will be. Child of God, what we be will not be. What we be can only become by what you accept through your mouth and your confession. With our hearts we believe, but with the mouth confession is made to salvation. You're going to cry. There is a way to cry to God. There is crying to God. Crying to God catches his attention. But when you attach faith to your cry, meaning the cry of faith to God catches God's attention but also moves his hand into action. You're going to lay your hands on your head. I'll give you 3 minutes to cry. Father in heaven, deal bountifully with me that I may live. That I may live. That I may live. That I may live and keep thy word. Lift your voice up and begin to pray where you are. You have 3 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes. My Father, as I begin to pray, deal bountifully with me, O God. Masha da 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 dasha, masakata dasha. Deal bountifully with me, that I may live. Deal bountifully with me, Lord. Makasika tabadasha. I refuse to avail myself before you and go home without the availing of your glory upon me. Deal bountifully with me through the release and the availing of your glory upon my life. Deal bountifully with me. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Lift your voice and begin to pray. Deal bountifully with me. Begin to pray. Father, deal bountifully with me. Open your mouth and begin to cry to him. begins to cry for the Lord to deal bountifully with you. Ha! If the man of God in Psalm 119 verse 17 still had to cry to God for God to deal bountifully with him, Malabalagadash, it shows the importance of crying for a bountiful impact. Deal bountifully with me, oh God. Deal bountifully with me. Deal bountifully with me. You have 2 more minutes to cry to the Lord, whether you're watching virtually or you're here physically. Deal bountifully with me. Please open your mouth and begin to cry. As I sing, just begin to just keep praying, keep praying. You're the all-consuming fire. I worship you today. Please begin to cry. You have 2 minutes. All-consuming fire, come and manifest yourself. You are the all-consuming fire. I worship you today. You are the all-consuming fire. Consuming fire, I worship you today. You are the all-consuming fire. Come and manifest yourself. You are the all-consuming fire. We worship you today, Father. Bountifully deal with us tonight, that we may live, oh God, on this angelic visitation's night. It's a covenant day of angelic visitation. Father, let there be an expression of your power, an unveiling of your glory, manifestation of your presence. A touch that brings supernatural and aura turnaround. Lift your voice and begin to pray wherever you are. Please pray, 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 pray. You have 1 more minute. Table your matter. It's angelic visitation service. Angelic visitation day. A date in God's diary to change your story. A date in Jehovah's diary to rewrite your destiny. You have 30 more seconds. Of Jesus. Just with your hands on your head, I want to speak over your life. Everything that you have mentioned on this altar, everything that you have released in prayer, that 3 minutes release from your mouth, I decree and I declare that by the reason of these divine dates with the Lord, and by your obedience in connecting with God's work, God's move, and God's word in this day, everything you have petitioned, they shall turn to materialization. Everything you have asked God, as long as they are in line with His perfect will for you, none shall leave this place without answers in the name of Jesus. I don't think you're hearing me. You are not permitted to leave this place. You are not permitted to leave this place without the answers you desire in the name of Jesus. And I want to specially prophesy that the angels of God sent out to minister to you and I this day, these angels are not permitted to return back to heaven without the delivery of the blessings that carries your name in the name of Jesus. I don't think you heard me. A woman was dying in the wilderness, the servant of Sarah. Despite being an Egyptian, she cried because she didn't want to see her son die, Ishmael. And an angel of God with a name in his mouth called out to her. Every time an angel leaves heaven, there is always an allocated charge for one person. I am praying that the angel that left heaven today, Hebrews 1:14 says, are these not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister to them that shall be heirs of salvation? The angel that has been sent out today with a charge carrying your name, I see that angel is not permitted to leave the dominion of men without you receiving your answers. That angel is not permitted to return back to the Father without you receiving your testimony. That angel is not permitted to return back to the celestial realm without you receiving your terrestrial blessings. In the name of Jesus. And so shall it be. In Jesus' name. Please, you can rise up and please be seated. As we grab our notepads, our pens, we run through the word quickly. We take a few prayer points and then we share the grace. I shouldn't be teaching you people about changing the keys when I'm ministering. The King James, you should know that by now. It's over 1 year. You should have learned that. Break your Bibles with me to Psalm 118, verse 22. Psalm 118, verse 22. I know some of you must have been, because when I walked into the hall, there was a type of smell and a feel like a smoky air. But please don't be alarmed. It's just our security system we have in here. Day before yesterday, we had a trigger of the alarm, and the security we have in the building activated. And it's part of the smell you're getting, so please don't be alarmed. I don't want to give away what the security is. If not, it's no longer security. But don't be alarmed. Psalm 118, verse 22. Everyone on Apostolic TV, God bless you and welcome to our angelic visitation service. Can you please give me the key for ministration? It reads, and I quote, "The stone which the builders refused is become the headstone of the corner." Verse 23. "This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes." Verse 24 says, "This is the day which the Lord hath made. We will rejoice and be glad in it." Father, bless the reading of the word in the name of Jesus. Child of God, I bring us a message titled, "I am not an underdog." I am not an underdog. I am not an underdog. The Bible says in Psalm 118, verse 22, "The stone which their builders refuse is become the headstone of the corner." There are many people who have found themselves in positions today that have caused even your family members to write you off. There are situations many are passing through this very hour that has made even your peers disregard your presence. There is so much a lot of people are going through. They hide themselves and their faces from the gathering of certain group members. Because when you arrive, people don't see evidence of your qualification. Educated to a professorial level, but yet nothing seems to be working in life. Professorial degree but cannot get a job, how much more keep a job? Married very early but don't have the fruit of marriage to show.
The Bible says in Psalm 118 verse 22 that the stones that the builder rejected has become the chief cornerstone. Meaning the Lord has sent me to tell someone on this angelic visitation service that wherever you have been rejected, discarded, and placed at the back, God said it's about to change your position. I don't think you heard me. From the back, the Lord is about to bring someone to the front. Okay, I will start with you. From the back, God is about to bring you to the front. Those people that said you will amount to nothing and you will not amount to something, God is about to bless you in front of them. I don't think you are hearing me. If you suffer rejection, this message is not meant for everybody. This message is meant for those who are tired of the backseat in life. This message is meant for those who are tired of rejection in life. This message is meant for those who are tired of repeated failure in life. I am yet to speak to someone who wants to start succeeding. I am yet to speak to someone who wants to change their position. I am yet to speak to someone who wants to change their level. The Lord has sent me to tell you that the rejected stone is becoming the chief stone of the corner. I don't know who that rejected sister is. I don't know who that rejected brother is. Hear me, child of God. The Lord has not forgotten you. And a word has been sent for tonight. Very simple word. The word is, child, your position is changing. Situation is changing. Position is changing. Situation is changing. Position is changing. Situation is changing. Lift your hands and say, Father, I receive change tonight. Please be seated. What does it mean when you say, I am not an underdog? There are three things I want you to pencil down in your notepad. Because through this entrance of these words, faith will be boosted. The Bible says, the entrance of the word giveth light and understanding to the simple. The Bible further says, faith comes by hearing, hearing the word of God. So what is the word of God for us tonight? Three things. The message titled, I am not an underdog, is a prophetic declaration for change of identity, change of situation, and change of position. Tonight's message is a prophetic declaration for three things I want you to pencil down. Change of identity, change of situation, and change of position. Three things you must note about tonight's message. I am not an underdog. It's not just a message, it's a confession you must release. Whenever you remember tonight, let it be a charge for you to speak and tell the devil, I am not an underdog. God never created us to be dominated but to have dominion. God never created us to be subdued but to subdue. God never created us to be afflicted and dried up but what? To be fruitful and replenish. Three things. I am not an underdog is a prophetic declaration for what? Number one, change of what? Identity. Number two, change of situation. And number three, position. But what does it mean? I am not an underdog. The word I am is not just a statement. It's not just something you say. You are talking about a living being. I am is the name of someone. The Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. I am is the name of someone. And that someone is Elohim, the God we serve. The Bible says in the book of Exodus, how God first formally introduced himself to man. That was the very first time God formally introduced himself to us with a name. God was speaking to Moses. Moses said, how can I go and talk to Pharaoh? Exodus chapter 3 verse 14. And God said, tell Pharaoh, I am that I am. And he said, thou shalt thou say unto the Israelites, I am has sent me unto you. The word I am is a word, or let me say it's a statement that many have used to put themselves in trouble. Whenever you say I am finished, what you are doing is you are using God's name to finish your life. I am done for. What you are doing is you are using the name of God to write yourself off. But when you are faced with challenges that want you to confess wrongly and negatively, you must remember that the first word I am is pivotal to what ends that statement. I am gives power to your speech. I am gives power to what manifests after your speech. Amen. And I am is what produces the desired effect you want to see in your life. God said, I am that I am. I can be what I want to be, whenever I want to be, however I want to be, without restriction or limitation. I am what I am. I am that I am. So when you say I am not an underdog, you are saying that I am a walking God. I am not an underdog. It means where God cannot fail, I cannot fail there. Where God cannot be beaten or be defeated, I cannot be beaten or defeated there. Where God cannot be afflicted, I cannot also be afflicted there. No matter the opposition, I am is what determines your position. No matter the situation, I am is what produces a solution. Are you understanding me? No matter the opposition, I am is what determines your position. No matter the situation, I am is what determines your solution. And no matter the personality, I am is what defines who the personality we see. The devil don't fear what you have. All of your accolades, no. The devil fears who you are and what you carry. If God be for me, who then can be against me? Romans chapter 8, verse 31. What shall we say then to these things? If God be for us, who can then be against us? Nobody. For through all these things, we are more than a conqueror. God never said that the enemy will not try, but his promises is that the enemy will not prevail. Amen. God never said you won't go through trials and tribulation, but he says after you have suffered a while, the God of all grace who has called us unto his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, he will perfect us, he will establish us, he will strengthen us, he will what? Settle us. Are you understanding me? God never said that the enemy will not touch your children. God never said the enemy will not touch your business. He said, even the gates of hell, when they come, they will not prevail. He said, I will build my church. Who is the church? You and I. It's not the building. Meaning God is particular about how you are built up in life. Don't let any situation make you sit on the back seat of life. We are meant to take the driving position. Amen. Front seat, first class seat. I am. Look at 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 10. Apostle Paul wrote a letter to the Corinthian church. He says, but by the grace of God, I am what I am. For a man to become anything in life, you need I am in what? In operation. By the grace of God, I am what I am. And his grace which was bestowed upon me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all. Yet not, but the grace of God which was what? With me. By the grace of God, I am what I am. I want you to lay your hands on your tabernacle. meaning your head, and declare over your life, I am not an underdog. I don't think I'm talking to someone I want to change their position. I am not an underdog. I am a walking God. I am not an underdog. I am a walking God. I am not an underdog. I am a God designed by the Almighty to dominate amongst men in the terrestrial, in the celestial. I shall dominate. No matter the powers rising up against me, militating against me, I am not an underdog. I shall not be oppressed. I shall not be battered. I shall not be defeated. I shall not be buried. I shall not live life a loser. Today, I become a victor in the name of Jesus. I am not an underdog. Remember, the next time you want to use the name of the Lord to justify negativity in your life, checkmate your words. Checkmate your tongue. Oh, sister, I am finished. Ah, you've used God's name to finish yourself. Don't use, I am is the name of the Lord. Let the weak say, I am strong. I am what I am by the grace of God. You see, Apostle Paul, he told the Corinthians, I am, this is what you say about me. I am what I am. Amen. By the grace of God. What does it mean when we say underdog? Remember, I said that the topic, I am not an underdog, is a prophetic declaration for your life to change your what? Your identity, your situation, and position. When the devil say you are dead, he say, no, I shall not die, but I shall live. To declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. What does it mean to be an underdog? An underdog is a competitor thought to have a little chance of winning a fight or contest. There are many people who start the week and start the day with a defeated mentality. How then can you make positive impact in your reality? You live in your life with a defeated mentality, you cripple your ability to change and impact your reality. Are you understanding me? A competitor thought to have a little chance of winning a fight or contest. Let me tell you something. And I want to bust the head of the devil tonight. Listen, the devil might have seen some of you, a competitor that have no chance of winning. But let me tell you something. When you are fighting an enemy that sees you as a loser, what happens is that enemy becomes too perplexed and complacent. Listen, you know, where you think that you cannot fight anymore, the Lord is saying now, he's changing that position of a loser and is now bringing the identity of a victor, and is changing your position to a victorious one. Are you understanding me? Underdog means a competitor who goes into a contest already losing before starting, lost before starting. A competitor thought to have little chance of winning a fight or a contest. Many of you fought so much spiritual warfare in your family, even to pray, you don't have energy again. You are now the underdog when it comes to the spiritual battles of your family. You are now the underdogs when it comes to the wicked oppressions of your uncles and your aunties. You are now the underdog when it comes to fighting the warfare that will set you free from wicked oppressions through blood covenant in your lineage. Child of God, I am here to tell you, you are not living yet defeated anymore. You are not living yet that underdog. You are not living yet that underdog. In the battle of your life, in the battle of your family, in the battle of your lineage, God shall fight for you. The Bible says the battle is the Lord. The Lord shall fight for you. If God be for you, who then can be against you? If God be for you, who then can fight against you? One with God is majority. I see God giving you a major victory. I see God giving you a major victory. I see God giving you a major victory. I see God giving you a major breakthrough. I see God giving you a winning lifestyle. I see God giving you a victorious lifestyle. Lift your voice, shout victory. Please be seated. A competitor thought to have a little chance of winning a fight or contest. Look at another definition of the word underdog. An underdog can be defined as a loser or predicted loser in a struggle or contest. Some people have seen you as a loser in life. Oh, that one, please. That means they see you that it's finished. That's what I have. We just celebrated Easter. When the devil got Jesus to be nailed and slaughtered on the cross, I'm sure the devil said, that's what, please. If only the devil knew that the cross was Jesus' promotion to power. If only the devil knows that your present affliction is nothing compared to the glory that's about to be revealed in you, they will not mock you. Am I understanding? Am I saying something here? You know what you are going through today is bringing mockery. I don't know why I'm addressing you. What you are going through today might be bringing mockery. Eh? But listen, your present affliction, your present persecution, your present struggle, the present situation is nothing compared to the glory that is about to be revealed in you. And I prophesy over the lives of someone here under the sound of my voice. They might be saying, what is not, nothing good shall come out of you. Understand me. When Jesus was found by Philip, and Philip went to get Nathanael, the Bible says, and Philip said to Nathanael, come and see the Jesus that Moses the prophet and Isaiah the prophet wrote about. And Nathanael's response was, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Child of God, it might be your story where people are saying, can anything good come out of you? I am here to tell you, after tonight, lots of good things shall come out of you. Out of your belly shall flow rivers of water. Out of your body shall flow rivers of living water. The word living water means good news. The word living water means testimony. The word living water means joy. I prophesy, out of your life shall flow good news. Out of your life shall flow good things. Have they said, can anything good come out of you? Child of God, good things shall come out of you. You become a container of good things. You're going out, you shall be a container, a carrier, a manifester of good things. I want you to lay your hands and say, good news and mercy follow me. Please be seated quickly. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? Mark chapter 10 verse 31, it says, but many that are first shall be the last, and the last first. Don't worry who seems to be prospering over you today. It's one thing for a man to prosper and be humble. It's another thing for a man to prosper and oppress others. Some people might be, it look like they are prospering and then they are oppressing you. But Mark chapter 10 verse 31, Jesus said, but the first shall be the last, and the last the first. Because you are last today, it's not your permanent site. I don't think you heard me. Your current position is not your permanent site. I say your current position is not a permanent site. It's a temporary location, and I see God relocating you now to your permanent destiny. God is moving someone to a permanent site. Your permanent site is called joy. Your permanent site is called peace. Your permanent site is called laughter. Your permanent site is called a new song. In the name of Jesus. Please be seated. But the many that are first shall be last. Mark 10:31. Look at what the Bible says. I already gave us John chapter 1 verse 45 and verse 46. Where Philip got Nathaniel. Come and see. Come and see. You know, there are some things that will happen in a man's life that has been written off. Even after it happens, people will say it's a lie. Have you seen someone that has suffered so much, suddenly is a multimillionaire? Your mockers will not believe it. Because they've written you off so bad, they don't see anything possibly happening for you that is good. Are you understanding me? John chapter 1 verse 45 and verse 46, it tells us about Philip finding Nathanael in verse 45 and saying, come and see the Jesus, the one that was prophesied, the one that was written about, the one that was promised to humanity. When Nathanael heard this, Nathanael's response in John 1 46 was, can anything good come out of Nazareth? Do you see how Nazareth was written off? Can anything good come out of that barren woman's womb? Can anything good come out of that man's life? But I love what Philip said to Nathanael. He said, come and see. Come and see in verse, is it verse 46? It says, come and see. Verse 45, it says, come and see. Come and see. Meaning, testimony, evidence. The best way to talk about your God is not in just talking scripture. It's in the evidence you are carrying. You know, you don't need to tell anybody too much story. When people have said you cannot be anything, and you now become the one feeding them. Listen, I see God giving you evidence that will make people say, come and see. There is someone's name that has been changed to come and see tonight. Your name is changed to come and see. 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 It won't be seeing bad things but good things. It won't be seeing negative things but positive things. I see God changing someone's story that will rewrite the history of your lineage. In the name of Jesus. Come and see, they said. Philip had to run. See, Philip became an evangelist of what Jesus was. Do you know that one thing? There are two news that spreads faster than good news. There are two types of news that spreads quicker than good news. It's called bad news and shock news. Now listen to me. There are two types of news. You know, when you are doing so many good things, people don't pick those ones. It's what is supposedly a bad thing, it spreads like wildfire. But listen, good publicity or bad publicity, everything is publicity. Are you understanding me? You might have been published as a barren woman. You might have been published as a bad wife. You must have been published as a woman that is defeated, and any devil in your lineage can come and just batter you. But listen, there is a republishing tonight. That republication is bringing the shock news. That will dumbfound those that said you will not amount to anything. That will dumbfound and shut the mouth of your mockers. That will shut the mouth of the devourer of your family. In the name of Jesus. May God give you a shock news. May you be a carrier of shock news. You might not understand what shock news means. When a man is a carrier of shock news, it means his life is suddenly bearing gigantic fruits that people never expected you to carry. I prophesy tonight. May God perform the unexpected in your life. May God perfect the unexpected in your life. May God use your small size to bring down the mighty giants of the family. In the name of Jesus. I just heard the Lord say he's about to use your small size to make and to write a gigantic story. story and Easter in your family in the name of Jesus. Please be seated. 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 9 says, but ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation or an holy nation, a peculiar people, that you may what? Show forth. Someone say show. God did not create your glory to be hidden. He created your glory to show. Do you know that you are God's masterpiece placed in a show glass to humanity? That is why I don't care what any devil has got to say about me. I know what I am. The kind of show glass God has created me to then display me, it takes celestial security force to guard me. You don't understand me. When you go to Argos, they sell wristwatch. Eh? They put it in show glass. They use key to lock it. When you go to goldsmiths, how many of you have bought watch from goldsmiths before? Goldsmiths, they don't just use key. They have alarm system on the glass. If you touch the glass anyhow, pwah, 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 police will turn up. Now, there are different grades of wristwatch sellers you go to. When you go to a place where they sell one watch, £20,000 for one wristwatch, the kind of security system there is serious. And there are some wristwatch that they don't put in show glass. It is the security department of a company that will book a special appointment with you, and they will bring it to your house, because this kind of watches go to like 500,000, 1 million. So you need to be, when you want to buy such watch, they need to know what your bank account is. I'm going somewhere tonight. They will ask you what your bank account is. Yeah? What they will now do is, you will have to send it to them, evidence. Yeah? And when they see your bank account, they will know that even though the watch gets stolen in transition, you can pay for it without having it. So the security men will come with a staff authorized with the gold. They will bring it to your house and they will allow you to check it and see if you want to buy it. Child of God, I am God's masterpiece. This, I might be going through a challenge today, and I might look like a Primark product, but understand, in time I become the primed one marked for glory. I don't think you are hearing me. You might see me as a Primark product today, but understand that I am prime marked for glory, and in time I will become the talk of town. I will become the celebrated one. I am not what I am going through. You are not what you are faced with. Listen, there are people who are going through a lot, and people label you, they give you a name by your challenge. The Bible says, and there was a man born lame, and he was sat by a gate called Beautiful. The gate had a name, but the man did not have a name. Instead, the man's name was crippled. The Bible says in the book of John and in the book of Mark that a man who was born palsy, he was born paralyzed. The Bible says his friends lifted into the roof of the house. They tore the roof and they brought the man, they let the man down. Now, the Bible did not give him a name. The Bible gave him a name by his sickness. There are people who have stayed too long in a position, and their position has become their identification. Child of God, the Lord has sent me to tell you that position that you have been in it for so long, that position that has now become a mockery in your life. People don't call you by your name anymore. They start calling you by your problem, by your challenge, by your heartache, by your pain. God is changing your story. I say, God is changing your story. I say, God is changing your story. I say, God is changing your story. You will not be known as that poor man anymore. In fact, when people want to address you, they will say, honorable. May God change your story. May God change your position. May God change your situation. If you believe, somebody shout glory. Please be seated. I am God's masterpiece to my generation. God did not place me in some cheap show glass. Awesome. You understand me? For ye are a what? A chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and a holy nation. You are peculiar. Don't let what you are going through make you look down on yourself. Some people just see you going through a challenge. They want to judge you by the challenge. But you don't know where I'm coming from. You don't know where I'm going to. If some people were to see your destiny on your forehead, they will worship you today. But don't worry. Before glory comes mockery. Before glory, mockery is what you experience. A man who has never been mocked in his life, it means you are nothing in life. Great men must first be mocked and laughed at. But it is left to the man himself to decide if he's going to be great at all. Are you understanding me? Yet though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. The valley of the shadow of death. I will fear. Fearing no evil, dear, is determining not to be threatened by the opposition that stands in the way between your position and your destiny. They that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under. There are two types of shadow, you must understand. There is shadow of death and shadow of the Almighty. Two types of shadow. There is shadow of death, Psalm 23, and there is shadow of the Almighty. It is the shadow of the Almighty that gives you an identity. Men should not see you, they should see God's representation upon you. You are not an underdog. You are a walking God. Are you understanding me? Oh, he has lived in England for 40 years, nothing to show. Don't worry. Moses stayed in the wilderness for 40 years. Give it time. When it's a man's time, nobody can stop it. When it's your time to shine, nobody can kill your star. When it's your time to emerge, nobody can stop you. Listen. The Lord said it's someone's time tonight. 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 In the name of Jesus. Isaiah chapter 53 verse 3 tells us about how Jesus was despised. Isaiah 53 verse 3. He is despised and rejected of men. A man of sorrows. He didn't say a man of sorrow. A man of sorrows. And acquainted with grief. And we hid as it were our faces from him. He was despised. And we esteemed him not. Child of God, are you going through sorrow? Jesus went through sorrows. Let me pluralize what you are going through, because Jesus has gone through it many times. God in the flesh was made mockery by man he created. How much more you? But that did not redefine Jesus. Jesus stood by his godly identity. The day you take your eyes off your life's assignment, you become a nonentity in life. Don't let people's mockery make you then change your walk to destiny. People laugh at you. I don't like the way you look. Who cares? Do you feed me? Even the one you like, how much do you give them? Eh? Jesus in Isaiah 53 verse 3. He was despised and rejected of men. People you have been sent to help reject you and despise you. A man of many sorrows. A man, not singular, plural. Acquainted with grief. What does acquainted mean? What does it mean to acquaint with something? Eh? Familiar. What else? Associate. Meaning everything about Christ's life on earth was grief. It turns to the left, grief. Turns to the right, grief. Turns, look forward, grief. Look backward, grief. But thank God, Jesus didn't take his eyes off God's child. Because eventually, despite the sorrows, despite the grief, despite the pain, it became highly exalted and given a name above every other name. That the same people that grieved him, the same people that pained him, the same people that sorrowed him, they bowed to him. God is changing your position. Wherever you have been mocked in your family, I say God is changing your story. Whoever said you will not amount to anything, I see God changing your story. I see God changing your identity. The same people that rejected you and placed you at the back, now I prophesy that they become the ones that will celebrate you as the chief stone of the corner. In the name of Jesus, I want you to jump where you are and say, my story changes tonight. I want you to declare by faith, my story changes tonight. I am not an underdog. I am not an underdog. I am not an underdog. I am a walking God. I am a walking God. I am not an underdog. I am a walking God. Lift your right leg up. Before we pray tonight, everyone remain standing. We're going to pray. Before we pray tonight, now hear me. Remain standing. We're going to pray. The Bible says in 1 Samuel chapter 17, there was a small boy called David and a giant called Goliath. You know what made me laugh? Is how the Bible describes Goliath. The Bible says, and Goliath was a champion of the camp of the Philistines. There are times you are faced with an opposition with a great credential and you look at yourself, you have no certificate. Automatically, you become an underdog by your own reasoning. You are trusting God for your papers. And they say, you know, if it was EU, you know, I would have been easily getting my paper. But in the UK, it's very hard, though. I have no right to stay, to get my leave to remain. Goliath was a champion of the camp of the Philistines. A man from Gath. Gath was a place that breeds warriors. Sons of the Anakims. Goliath had a proven track record of victory in battle. David was a keeper of sheep. But what Goliath did not know was that God was teaching David how to use a weapon that Goliath cannot defend himself against. In the process of your pain, God gives you a strategy for your eventual victory. Hear me? If David was in the army, he would not have defeated Goliath. Are you understanding me? Do you know why I'm saying this? If David was in the army, he could not have defeated Goliath. Why? David would have been used to swords and shields and spear. And Goliath was trained to fight those kind of weapons. But when David showed up in the book of 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 40, and he took his staff in his hand and chose him 5 smooth stones. David was used to using stones to fight animals that came to steal his father's flocks. Listen, you know what you are going through today? You are failing to understand that God is giving you a strategic weapon in your hand that will be pivotal to the battle ahead of you. Listen, don't mock the days of your pain. Don't mock the days of your current challenge. Because in your today, God is building a weapon in your hands that the devil has not fought against. And with that comes unpredictability that makes you ascend victoriously when you are opposed by Goliath. When Goliath saw David picking up stones and catapult and his staff, Goliath said, am I a dog? Am I a dog that you are coming with stones? Now I will feed your flesh to the birds of the air. David said, no, you don't understand. You see these stones? When I was keeping my father's flocks, a bear came. And with these stones, I went after I knocked it down. A lion came. With these stones, I went after I knocked it down. You uncircumcised Philistines. Today you are going down. David refused to be an underdog to a qualified enemy. Listen, for you to fulfill a great destiny, God will make you fight an enemy overqualified than you. I don't think you are hearing me. There is no great man that fights and wins where others have fought and won. What makes you great is fighting a new battle and taking a new territory. So you need strategy for the victory. Are you understanding me? Catapult and stone. How many of you know what catapult is? I'm saying catapult. Let me speak in the British accent. Catapult. Catapult. And I'm speaking with Nigerian accent. Catapult. I'm talking about, how would they say it in English? British accent. Catapult. Catapult. David picked up a catapult. Five smooth stone. When Goliath saw David coming, Goliath did not know that Jesus said, "Upon this rock I will build my church." And Jesus himself is a stone, not mud. J-E-S-U-S. David picked up grace from the ground to bring Goliath down to his feet on the ground. Listen, we are going to pray tonight. Father, anything that has threatened my dominion in life, whatsoever has threatened my dominion in life, making me live like an underdog tonight, by this angelic visitation service, come down in the name of Jesus. Lift your voice and Allah, my Father, my Father, my Father, my Father, as I begin to pray, oh Lord, whatsoever, anything that has brought me down, that has dominated me, that has taken my power of dominion, anything that has troubled me, troubled my peace, today, by the power of God, by the power of the Holy Ghost, you devil, you are coming down tonight. You are coming down tonight. I engage the mysteries of warfare, the mysteries of kingdom warfare, and I come against you, you devil, in the name of the Lord. Lift your voice and begin to fire prayer in the name of Jesus. Begin to pray where you are. Begin to pray where you are. I don't care how long you have been defeated. Malabalagadash. Pray, 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 pray. I don't care. Mashadadadadadadadash. Malabalagadabalagadash. Don't care. What is that devil that has threatened my dominion, threatened my peace, threatened my life? Today, as I pray, today, as I pray, 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 pray. You devil, you are coming down. Down. Pray, 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 pray. Pray, pray, pray. Pray, 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 pray. Malabalagadabalada. In the name of Jesus. Listen, listen, listen. I don't think David fought Goliath like this. The mentality David used to fight the entity called Goliath came with ruggedity to change his entirety, birthing God's kingdom reality for his existence. You can't pray like this. I said the message tonight is titled what? I am not an underdog, and I broke down the word I am. I am is not just a statement, it is the name of God. So when you say I am not an underdog, you are saying God is changing my position. God is changing my situation. And God is changing my identity. We're going to take 3 prayer points tonight. After the first one, we just take it. 3. Identity must change. Situation must change. And position must change. Father, as I lift my voice up in prayer, today I begin to walk, listen to this, with the knowledge and the power of your word concerning my life. That births a new identity. The moment you begin to walk like the exact way God has spoken concerning you, your identity changes. I always say this, I don't see anybody fit enough to kill me. Nobody is fit enough. You must first kill God. If you cannot kill God, you cannot touch me. How can someone sit in his house and call my name into a calabash and the person don't die there? Mistake. Something is wrong there. Can you call Elohim into a calabash? Can you call Jesus Christ into a calabash? Then why are they calling names of believers into calabashes? Lift your right hand of power. You are going to cry to God. Someone say, my father, my father. I'm looking for those. Where are the Davids that want to tear down and pull down strongholds tonight? Someone say, my father, my father. As I begin to pray, oh Lord. As I begin to pray, oh Lord, from this hour, I begin to walk and I choose to engage the knowledge and the power of God concerning my identity, concerning my life, concerning my life, concerning my existence. I am what God says I am. Lift your voice and begin to pray in the spirit. Begin to penetrate realms as you engage the right identity tonight. Stopping every demonic deity that wants to kill God's agenda for your reality. Open your mouth and fire prayer. My identity must change tonight as I gain the power and the knowledge and the power of God's mind concerning my life. God, Father, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, as I begin to pray, I am what I am. By the grace of God, Apostle Paul said to the Corinthians, so today, oh God, I engage the very knowledge you have concerning my existence. I refuse to live below power. I refuse to live below the standard you have designed for me. Tonight, this angelic visitation service, I rise up and I become that which God says I am. I am a dominator, not to be dominated. God has appointed me a royal priesthood. God has designed me a holy nation. God has manifested me as a peculiar person. I refuse to live less than that. I am royalty. I am a son of divinity. Hey, the rocketity needed for my entirety, for my entity, to scatter every satanic deity, so that my reality must receive power and change. I engage you tonight. Begin to pray where you are. Pray for your identity. You are a chosen generation. The Bible says, sing, O barren, child of God, even in what looks like barrenness. God is saying you should sing, because in your singing comes your fruitfulness. In your singing comes your victory. Father, as we pray, oh God, we engage the very knowledge and the power of your mind concerning our life. Pray. Hey, open your mouth and pray. You have 2 more minutes. This angelic visitation service, I begin to walk with divinity. Divinity must touch my identity. Divinity must touch my identity. I refuse to be what the devil says I am. I refuse to be what the devil has predicted against me. I am what God says I am. I stand on God's knowledge. I stand on God's power concerning my existence, concerning my entire. In the name of Jesus, let me see a new identity. Amen. I said three things we should take home tonight. I am not an underdog. It's a prophetic declaration for what? Change of what? Identity. Change of what? And change of what? We're going to deal with the situation now. The last time people saw you, they saw you in a place where that made them mock you. But the next time they will see you, they will see you in a place that will make them celebrate you. Remember, I talked about John chapter 1, verse 45 and 46. Philip saw Jesus, the manifestation of prophecy. He went to get Nathanael. In John 1, 46, Nathanael told Philip, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Listen, after this prayer we are going to take now, the kind of news they will hear from your camp, the kind of news your mockers will hear from your camp. Thou prepares a table before me in the presence of my mockers, in the presence of my enemies, in the presence of those that have written me off. Listen, you are going to pray now for a change in situation. Listen, the Bible says in John 14, 18, "I will not leave you comfortless, I will come to you." The Lord is about to comfort someone with the good news. God is about to comfort someone with breakthrough. Lift your hands and your voice and shout, "My Father, my Father." I don't think someone here, I'm talking to you. If I'm talking to you, lift your voice and shout, "My Father, my Father." As I begin to pray, destiny changing God, destiny changing God, name rewriting God, entity rebuilding God, locate me tonight and change my situation. Give me good news, give me the news and the testimony that will dumbfound the reasoning of my mockers, that will cause my mockers to come and celebrate God with me. Lift your voice, open your mouth and fire prayer. Destiny changer, identity rebuilder, glory refurnisher, hey, life refurbisher, situation changer. As I open my mouth in prayer, let there be a performance in my life that causes situations to change. That where the mockers thought I will end up being nothing, the same people that laughed at me will come and laugh with me. Those that said, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Indeed, something good and the best thing that humanity can see came out of Nazareth. Guinness Book of Record has not broken the record Nazareth broke through the manifestation of Jesus Christ. Lord, let me be the next big thing of my generation. I am what God says I am. The situation that has kept me in a place of mockery, the situation that has kept me in a place of absolute battery, the situation that has kept me in a place of negative laughter, as I lift my voice in prayers, as I lift my voice in prayers, oh Lord, oh Lord, please pray. You have 2 more minutes. Please pray for yourself. Situation locating God, identity changing God, glory refurbishing God, life transforming God. Hey, locate me tonight. Lord, I refuse to stay in this position. I cannot be a crippled man positioned by a beautiful gate. Change my situation. change my situation, oh God. Hey, with change of situation comes change of position. Father, change my situation. Change this situation, oh God. I cannot die like this. I cannot live like this. For your word says in Psalm 119. Oh Lord, your word says, Father, deal with us bountifully that we may live. Lord, deal with me bountifully by touching my situation. Deal with me bountifully by touching my situation. Psalm 119 verse 17. Deal bountifully with thy servant that I may live and keep thy word. Father, deal bountifully with me that there shall be a physical change in my situation that I may live. I refuse to just be alive and not live, Lord. I want to be alive and I want to live. Hey, Malabalagadasha. You have 1 more minute to cry to the Lord tonight. You move mountains, you cause walls to fall with your power. You perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. Now I'm standing here, only you, 'cause you made a way. Now I'm standing here, only because you made a way. Way maker, a miracle. Now we are going to deal with the last one before we go tonight. Position. You know that you can be the firstborn in your family, but by the reason of bad situations, you are treated like the gateman. Do you not? On the other hand, a gateman's position is to lock the gate. A gateman to every palace determines who comes through into the palace, right? But yet, no one reverences the gateman. Everyone is concerned about the man inside the palace. Position is everything in life. We are going to pray. The position that will bring me to honor. Amen. Father, plant my feet here tonight. Amen. Listen to it carefully. The position that will bring me to honor. Father, plant my feet. Establish my feet there. David, the moment he saw people were cowering away, David asked Saul, Saul, what shall be given to the man that defeats Goliath? Saul said, I will give the man so plus my daughter. David said, okay, I'm ready. A shepherd boy saw an opportunity to marry the daughter of a king. Position change. By the reason of a change of situation. David was given an opportunity to fight rebattle, no more fighting with animals in the bush. We're going to the position that will bring me to honor. Father, plant and establish my feet there. Did you get a prayer point?
Yes, sir.
The position, listen, you cannot break record and your father's house don't honor you. Many of you, you are firstborns, but yes, they have family meeting without your approval. In my family, by the grace of God, after they've had their family meeting, when they finish, they will still gather themselves and say, let us wait for what John will say. And you know, most of the time, I'll say, well, everything you have discussed, zero. Let's start again. You say, but we should have contacted him first. Because why? I'm bringing something more than gold and silver. It's called the prophetic eye.
Amen.
I say, listen, God said, do this, do this, do that. So now they don't have meeting again. What they do is, let's speak to man of God. Even last night, my brother called me. He said, man of God, please see for me. That's my own brother. I said, what do you want the Lord to do for you? Let's talk. I was driving and I was seeing for him. My eyes was open because the grace of God is upon my head. And I was telling him what to do. He shook head. He said, I've been thinking about this thing 4 years ago. Why didn't I speak to you since? Something more than gold. I've got something more than gold. Something more than silver. I have something more than gold. The Spirit of the Lord within me is something more than gold. The Spirit of the Lord within me is something more than gold. We're going to pray. Listen, the position that brings to honor. Imagine being governor. Who wants to talk to anyone in your state? You are in charge of everything that goes out and comes in. Joseph became prime minister of Egypt. Potiphar what became his PA. You know the story of Potiphar, right? Potiphar was the same man that imprisoned Joseph. After Pharaoh made Joseph prime minister, Potiphar became his personal assistant. The same man that made Joseph a prison attendee, PA, now became Joseph's own personal assistant, PA. Position change. We are going to pray. The position that brings to honor. Father, plant my feet and establish it there. You are going to lay your hands on your head. And you will be crying, you will be shouting. Mark, today is the 8th of April 2021. You will understand what God is about to do. Lay your hands on your head. And begin to say, my Father, as I begin to pray, oh Lord, the position that brings to honor, the position that brings to honor, oh Lord, let my feet be planted and be established there. I give you 3 minutes, open your mouth and begin to speak to the Lord. Begin to speak to the Lord. Begin to speak to the Lord. The position that brings to honor, let my feet be well planted and established there. Open your mouth and begin to pray. The position that brings to honor, the position that brings to honor, let my feet be planted and fully established there. The position that brings to honor. Please pray, 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 pray. The position that brings to honor. Let my feet be planted and let it be established there. Open your mouth and pray. Open your mouth and begin to pray. Lay your hands on your head and speak. Speak. Your head is your horn. But my horn shall the Lord exalt like the horn of a unicorn. Psalm 3 verse 3 says, you are my shield, you are my glory, and the lifter up of my head. Lay your hands on your head. Pray. The position that brings to honor. The position that brings to honor. Let my feet be planted and well established there. Let my feet be planted and well established there. Please open your mouth and pray. You have 2 more minutes. You are putting a seal on today's assignment. Angelic visitation. You cannot be visited by God and your life remains the same. The position that brings to honor. Let my feet be planted and well established there. You have 1 minute, 30 seconds to pray. Please pray, pray, pray. Begin to speak to your life. Father, the position that brings to honor, establish my feet. The position that brings to honor, let my feet be planted and established there. Begin to pray, pray, pray in the name of Jesus. You have 1 more minute to pray. The position that brings to honor, let my feet be established. Let my feet be planted there. I will matter in my family. Without me, nothing will move in my generation. I become a major player, a pace setter, a pathfinder in this time, in this season, for this cause the Lord has sent me. Open your mouth and begin to declare it. The position that brings to honor, Father, establish my feet, plant my feet, Lord. When you are rightly positioned by God, there is no opposition that can bring you down. There is no opposition that can challenge God's position when God lifts up a man. Pray, 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 pray. You have 1 more minute, 1 more minute, pray. The position, Father, as we pray, Lord, that brings to honor, plant and establish our feet. In the name of Jesus. Lift up your hands, I pray for you. Today is the 8th of April as instructed by God to engage. Now, 8 is the number of new beginnings. This is the 4th month in this year. 4 is the number of creation. By obedience to God's word and by reason of being here tonight, I pray that the Lord shall begin a new thing in your lives. Let this new thing change your identity. Let this new thing change and bring an end to every ungodly situation you find yourself. And let this new beginning plant and establish your feet in great positions that brings to honor and glory in the name of Jesus. And so shall it be in Jesus' most precious name.